In this video, I will explain you about profile maintenance. What are the profiles and parameters? The individual instances and the SAP system are configured using profile parameters. Means the instances and the SAP system are configured using some profile parameters. And the default values of these parameters are defined in the program code of the kernel. Okay, so we need to maintain these parameters using some methods. Okay, let us see what all the profiles are available in our system. There are three types of profiles available in SAP systems. First one is start profile. The start profile file name looks like start instance, instance number and host name. And the instance profile looks like SID of the instance and the instance number and the host name. And the default profile. And default profile is useful to all the instances of an SAP system. Instance profile is useful for only specific instance. And start profile will be used for starting the instance. Okay, let us see these three files in SAP system. And open operating system level files, computer, C drive, USR, SAP, and WD, sys profile. Here you have three files, you see. So this default profile, this is instance profile, this is start profile. Okay, so these three profile files are available for our profile maintenance. Okay, you can display the profile parameters using two ways. One is RZ11T code, and another way of displaying profile parameters is using RSPFPAR-T code, or the same RSPFPAR can be executed as report using SEA38-T code. Okay, so these are the methods to display the existing parameters available in the program code of kernel. Okay, so next is, and this is the table for displaying dynamically switchable profile parameters. So what is the meaning of dynamically switchable profile parameters? Whenever you are changing some parameter in the SAP system, you need to restart the instance to get the effects changed. Okay, so these, whatever the profile parameters are listed in this particular table, are dynamically switchable. So whenever you change the profile parameter of this dynamically switchable, there is no need to restart the server. Okay, and let us see the profile parameters by using the T code RZ11, and hit the T code RZ11. From here, if you know the profile name, that is profile parameter name, you can enter here and click on the display to get the values of that particular parameter. Okay, here if you don't know anything about the profile parameter names, just you can click on F4. It will list all the parameters which are available in the system. So right now it is showing only 500 entries, but you can click on this arrow mark to get all the list. Okay, just select start sets so that it will display all the parameters available in the system. There are 1247 entries found. Okay, you can open any of the parameter from here, like DIR, DIR underscore trans. This is one of the parameters. You can click on the display. So the directory of the transport, that is transport directory, is located at this location, that is NW7EHP1 SAP MNT trans. Okay, so it is actually network UNC path Okay, just I will show you the exact path of this particular directory in the SAP system. It is available in USR, C colon USR, SAP, trans directory. This is the directory it is showing at SAP system level. This is the directory. You can view the parameter in this way. So this is one type of displaying parameters. And another type is, another method is using RSPFPAR is the T code for displaying all the parameters available in the system. Okay, just click on the execute button from here. It will display all the parameters. Like for suppose whatever the parameter just now we have seen, that is DIR underscore trans, can be find from here. You see, this is the path of the file, and this is user defined value and system defined value also same. And the system default value is unsubstituted form. Before substituting the names, this is the form, that is SAP trans host, SAP MNT and trans. Here the SAP trans host is replaced with NW7EHP1. Okay, so in that way you can display the parameters, profile parameters in the system using RSPFPAR T code. And another method is RSPFPAR report. How to execute report? Just using SA38 is the executing report. Okay, RSPFPAR is there. Just enter it here and click on the execute button so that you can display all the parameters just as usual. How you have got the display when you use RSPFPAR T code, in the same way it will display all the parameters. This is dynamically switchable profile parameters can be executed using this table TPFY PROPT. And how to display the table? Just T code to display the table is SE16, and the table name is TPFY PROPT. Okay, you can click on this button, table content. It will show you all the list of parameters which are dynamically switchable. That means these parameters can be dynamically switchable. There is no need to restart the SAP instance to get the effect after change. Okay, next thing is here. So we have learned how to display the parameters. Now we need to maintain. If you want to change some parameter, what you will do? You need to have some way to change the parameter. So for that purpose, you have different types of profiles, as I have shown all these profiles at operating system level files, that is start profile, default profile, instance profile. Okay, these files to be imported into the database using SAP tools, then you can change the parameters. Let us see how to do that. Okay, so next slide is that. Okay, advantages. Let us come back to this at operating system level. So go back from here and execute RZ10 is the T code for importing the profiles, that is profile maintenance. To maintain the profile files, you need to use the RZ10 T code. Hit enter. So from here, first step you need to do, that is you need to import all the profiles available at operating system level to database level. Okay, let us import the profile files from operating system level to database level. Click on utilities and select import profiles of active servers. Okay, all the profile files will be imported into the database, and it is, those are available for maintenance. Just if you click on this button, that is possible options button, you can see all the profile files. Whatever the profiles we have seen at operating system level, those are available for maintenance now. Okay, for suppose if we start with start profile, you can select that and you can maintain. You have three options to maintain it. Okay, let us come back to the screen after seeing the slide. Okay, and what are the advantages to the user by administering profiles in the SAP system? Okay, the advantages are central administration and maintenance of the instances. You can maintain all the instances from single location. Okay, and changes in the profiles checked for consistency. Whatever the changes we do, that can be checked for consistency. Okay. And then administration of multiple versions of a profile. Whenever you are doing changes, the old one will be saved as a copy in the database so that it is available for reactivation. Okay. So that it will maintain all the versions of the profiles. And compare actively used profile and profile stored in the database. Whatever the profile is right now, it is active. It will be compared with the profile which is stored in the database. Okay. And then only the consistency is good and SAP system will work fine. And immediate activation of selected parameters, like we have seen the dynamically switchable parameters, some of the parameters will be immediately activated without restarting SAP instance. And next slide is importing profiles. We have already seen that, and utilities import profiles of active servers. And there are three levels of maintaining the profiles. We have three levels of maintaining the profiles. Those are administration data. So in the administration data contains the type of profile, short description, what is the type of profile and the description of that, and path of the file, the file where it is stored, and name of the instance and the time of the last activation. Okay, let us see that on the SAP screen. Click on the start profile. We start with the start profile. Double click on it and click on selected administrative data and click on display. So from here you can see the details about profile name. What is the profile name? That is start underscore dbebmgs, that is instance, and the instance number. Okay, and the host name. Okay, and the description of this profile is automatically generated import profile, and administrative data, the path of the file where it is stored. I have shown you this path, okay, in the SAP server, where C:\usr/sap/nwd/sys profile start underscore dbebmgs instance, and the 00 is the instance number and the host name. And then the reference server for profile parameters, check the reference server. Total name of the server is nw7ehp1, and the SID of the server, and the 00 is the system number, that is instance number, and Windows NT, the operating system is Windows NT. And the type of profile, what is the type of profile? Startup profile, and modified by the user, SAP user, and on date and at time, and activated by the user, SAP user, and the time. This is the activation time. Okay, in this way you can see the administrative information using this option, administrative data. Okay, and then basic maintenance. From here you can click on the display or change. If you want to change the parameters, you can use the change, and if you want to display only, you can click on the display. After clicking on the display, if you want to change the parameters, you again you need to go back and click on the change to change some information about some of the parameters. Okay, like this you can change the parameters from here. Okay, and next thing is that you can click on the extended maintenance, and you can click on the change to change the parameters. Okay, these parameters are showing as unformatted, that is technical names of the parameters is showing here. Okay, so from here you can change, as well as you can create new parameter also. Okay, it is not possible with the basic maintenance or administrative data, and only you can use extended maintenance to create new parameters. Okay, and in the same way, instead of start profile, if you want to select the instance profile, you have to select instance profile like this and click on the select extended maintenance, click on the change button to change the parameters. For suppose SAP system name is NWD, this is the parameter name and this is the parameter value. Okay, so from here directly you can change, or you can enter new parameter by clicking on this button. Okay, for suppose if you want to add some parameters, you can add some parameter from here and put the value and click on the copy, and so that the profile parameter will be added to the existing list of parameters. Okay, I am not doing that right now. Just I want to explain you what are all the options to maintain the profiles. Okay, so in that way you can maintain the profile parameters. Okay, what else is there? Basic maintenance. This allows you to adjust the most important parameters. Only some of the parameters can be adjusted using basic maintenance. And extended maintenance, it displays the technical names of the profile parameters and allows you to create new parameters. Apart from changing existing parameters, it will allow you to create new parameters. Okay, so next is consistency check. So you need to check the consistency between actively working profile and the profile which is stored in the database. How to do that? Go back to your SAP system. From here, go back. By staying here, click on the utilities and check all profiles of active servers. Okay, so that it will check the consistency and it will give you the report like this. Okay, everything is fine. No errors found, no errors found, no errors found. That means everything is working fine. Okay, so go back. So in this way, you can maintain the profile parameters. Okay, that's all about explanation about maintaining profiles. Thanks for watching.